Now you have installed the Ubuntu system, but to be identifiable on on the network, the network configuration has to be done. Network configuration means giving it your system a host name and the IP address, specifying a gateway, specifying a DNS server so that it can resolve different URLs. So how it can be done, I will show now. Okay, so for setting up a network, there are three files. Here are the files. So we have to enter the specifics in each of these files. So I will show one files one by one. You open a terminal, go to Applications, Accessories and Terminal. For doing network configuration, I am going to explain the steps. First, you change the root password using passwd command. It will ask for the current password of the user from which we are running this command, that is Swati. I am entering new password for the root. So now the root password is changed. So for doing the network changes, you do su enter. It will ask for the root password now. So the password that you have just set, you enter that password. And the user will be changed from Swati to root. Now you open the file /etc/host. This is the first file for the network configuration. You enter the IP address with which your system will be identified. You give a host name for the system. Like this, you save this file. The second file related to the networking is /etc/hostname. The same hostname that you specified in the /etc/host is to be specified here also. Save and close this file. The third file for the networking is /etc/network/interfaces. Open this file using vim. I will show you the typical structure of the interfaces file. I have opened one interfaces file in another terminal. So you write along with me. This information you already have in your interfaces file, that is the this file. Now we have to enter IP address, netmask, gateway. These things have to be entered in the our interfaces file. So you write along with me. Auto ETH0. So ETH0 is the interface on which we are configuring our IP address. Then iface ETH0 INET space static. You have to specify the IP address. The IP address will be the same that you specified in the host file, that is 10.105.11 dot your corresponding fourth octet. After that you have to write the net mask. Net mask is same as given 255.255.0.0. So basically this is the subnet in which we are working. So if you do AND of the IP address and net mask, you will get the domain in which we are working. So ending these two will result in 10.105.0.0. So this is the domain in which the systems are placed. The next thing is we have to specify the gateway. For our network, the gateway is 10.105.1.250. All the traffic outside the domain is routed through this gateway. You enter the same thing for this lab, 10.105.1.250. After that, you can specify the broadcast address. The domain is 10, our domain is 10.105, and this 255.255 specifies broadcasting is to be done to all systems which are in our domain. You save this file using escape shift colon WQ, enter. Now the network configuration in all the three files are done. To reflect it in the system, you have to restart a service. The service is there in /etc/init.d/networking. This is to be restarted using restart. It will reconfigure the network. After restarting the network, it gave a warning that this result.conf file is not present. So this warning is due to we have not specified the DNS server name. So whenever you enter a URL in the browser, it cannot resolve this URL or any host name unless we specify a name server. So where do we specify it? It is in the /etc/result.conf. You open this file using vim. I will copy contents of some other result.conf in our new file. You do the same thing. This is the our domain cse.iitb.ac.in. Names are hostname resolution. You have to specify DNS server name. So where do we specify this? Is in /etc/result.conf file. You open this file. And write this in that file. Here cse.iitb.ac.in is our domain name. And the DNS server is specified as this. Yeah, you have to specify the same address. This is the DNS server of our computer department. After doing it, save this file, escape, shift, colon, WQ, enter. Again, do restart networking, slash etc slash init.d slash networking space restart. Now that warning is gone. Okay, after you wrote the things in the result.conf, you have to again restart the network. So for restarting the network, this is the command, slash etc slash init.d slash networking, restart. After configuring a network, now you have specified the DNS server IP address. You can check this with using ping command. Host, it is cac.iitb.ac.in. Now, as you can see, as we have specified a DNS server, it resolved this machine to this IP address, and the ping is successful, as you can see from the output. For stopping the print ping, use Control C. After that, we will see ifconfig command. Go to the terminal and type ifconfig, enter. Now you will see the changes reflected in the output of ifconfig command. This is the ETH0 interface that we configured. This is the MAC address of our system. This is the IP address that we just specified, the broadcast address, and the netmask. So that means we have configured the network for this interface, and IP of our system is set to this field. Okay.